On May 30th, a post on a popular online community gained attention after mentioning that Olivia Rodrigo, official of the YouTube channel, was promoting Good For You in Korea, with the title song topped the Billboard charts competing with BTS. If you don't know who Olivia Rodrigo is, she's an 18-year-old singer and actress who had hit songs this year like Driver's License and Deja Vu, which was one of my favorite songs when it first came out. But according to a post of the netizen, he has never seen a pop singer use another singer's name to promote his or her song in Korea. The post immediately received support from the majority of online community. This is not the first time that the topic of using old hits to promote a new song has been analyzed and discussed. In the second half of 2018, a huge controversy broke out, with the netizens saying that they saw a Dance the Night Away ads while watching Blackpink's Doodoo music video and Fake Love by BTS. However, it is very common to run this ad based on old songs, and many other artists have similar strategies. It can be said that it is not wrong for Olivia to run an advertisement on another group's song. The other thing that the media did that led to Olivia being criticized was comparing the female singer to another group, even though the two songs were not related. Now, what do you guys think? Do you think it's a cheap game for other artists to play their ads for their songs when you're watching a different music video of a different group or artist, or is it fair game and they can do what they want when it comes to promoting their music? Let me know in the comments down below. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.